show him some of the shop. Mark does some hobby woodworking. What are you talking about?
We do lots of hobby here.
All right, let's get rolling. All right, things from last time. Jake's last day. Everybody loves Jake. Dustbin out every Wednesday night. That was a success. Thank you, Patrick.
Sweet.
And then submarine sound. We're going to start automating the meeting so we can get rid of the horn. So.
Except you won't be able to hear it. I just thought it was a video you guys would watch.
Yeah.
In the meantime, while we're honking the horn, can we not go so loud?
Yeah, it's like 150 decibels.
We don't have all the walls with it anymore.
Yeah. All right.
Pressure valve.
We'll do a little. Good idea. Cool. We'll get somebody on that.
Yes.
All right. We have one escape. We got a lost pedestal from FedEx, being remade right now and going out overnight. So I don't know a dollar value on it yet, but it's in the works. Escape for us is anything that doesn't get correctly ordered or shipped properly, or if we forget something on our end, so we consider that escape.
Anytime the customer is not happy.
Yeah. Better way to say it. Thank you. Yeah. All right. And see, I'm done. Anybody need help anywhere today? Cool. Sweet. All right. We have a new nomination for improvement of the week coming
curse
from Lingle with the Curse Core.
Curse Core.
All right. Couldn't get it to download into the meeting, so I have to do this today.
Oh, hello. Ben here with an improvement. Necessity, they say, is the mother of invention. In this case, hatred is the mother of this invention. Hatred of Curve Core. Here with us is a small, non-standard cylinder that would normally be made out of Curve Core. Instead, I curved the mold, used shrink wrap, and attained much higher quality. To set the height instead of rings, you've got this simple jig, and then spacers to set the overall height. Much higher quality, and no curved core. Also, a huge time saving. So time and quality, that about sums it up. Thanks a lot.
Cool.
Okay.
What phone was that taken on?
Cylinders
phone.
Okay. Crappy resolution. We'll take a look at it, see if we can up that quality.
Alright. I don't know anything about Curve Core, but I know it's a problem, so.
It is time consuming, and it's a lot more steps
heavy.
Involved.
Yeah, and heavier, so
that took half
more
the
money
time
to ship.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Huge improvement.
Then you gotta route a seam too.
Awesome. All right, we got to do some more video. We're getting close. We got about 15 minutes left. We'll try to go 1 1/4 speed to power through this.
Or 1.5.
1.5, let's try that.
Do I hear 4?
And you ride them, but you can't too much because you have an injury.
Because I have a lack of whiplash.
Right.
I've got a pinched nerve on my...
So you're not going to go motocross, right? Right.
No, no, no. I don't have any crossroad riding either on a bike or a four-wheeler SUV. All-terrain vehicle, I can't do any of them anymore.
Right, so in order for you to go to some of the villages because the roads are very bad, you have to do what?
I take a helicopter, and I didn't do that for a couple of years. I didn't go to the village
because you felt bad.
And
a little presumptuous to be landing in a poor village in a helicopter.
Exactly. And the helicopter ride costs more than what you spend for the village in a year.
Exactly.
So I was, when I landed, they all came and I told them, they said, look, you're abandoning us. I said, no, but I feel embarrassed about landing in an expensive helicopter to do village development. And the guy turned around and said, you come by rocket, but you come. Because if you don't come, you're causing us more harm than coming by helicopter. Nobody's going to misunderstand you. We've known you for 20 years. We know that you're not about your comfort and your convenience. But now you need it. And otherwise, you're not going to come. So he said, but you come any way you can, but you better get here.
Before it is furnished, because furnishing brings spirits with it.
Right.
Before it's furnished, you do a housewarming where you do chanting and bring good spirits in and keep and make it occupiable by your family.
Mm-hmm.
On the day the factory walls came up, and there was no machinery inside, there was nothing, an empty building, that day, after we finished the morning prayers and the whole morning, that night my father died.
And this is the first motorcycle factory?
Yes.
So he gave you the seed for the motorcycle factory.
I was the project manager.
But you had to grow the banyan tree.
I had to grow the banyan tree. Now, you can say that which is more important, the person who gave the seed or the person who grew the banyan tree?
Both.
But I think if somebody gave you the seed and you didn't grow it,
absolutely,
nothing comes out. But if you didn't give the seed, you couldn't have grown it. That's equally true. So in the same way, I have the seed of an idea of OCST,
But the person who gave it form and shape and the size is
Usher. That's beautiful. So he's grown up this incredible organization that's helping millions of people. You had the vision for it, and what's beautiful about that is it just tells a story of collaboration and integration and people working together and being connected, rather than the John Wayne syndrome as you describe it.
And also it's important to know the role of the owner and the role of the CEO. In my view, that I am an executive chairman owner. I own the legal entity and I'm responsible for all stakeholders, including society, shareholders, the stock exchange, the SEC, the customer, the employees. But the owner of the business is the CEO. And therefore, he's empowered to run the business, but he cannot tamper with the values, he cannot tamper with the governance structure and the stakeholders' interests. He can add to it, but he cannot detract from it.
One more time, what did your professor, your teacher?
He said you can always create a microcosm, which is infinitely better than the macrocosm, and a very high quality company. And this challenge you've met, your employees come from very poor environments, they've never seen electronics, they come in, and suddenly they're running modern CNC machines, robotics, they're running a clean plant. The cleanliness is not part of their
culture.
And so he said, this is how you start change. When many such companies grow up, then whole society will change. And today, if you go to any of my employees' homes, they're very clean.
They look different than the culture that they were
raised in, or the culture of the neighbor.
Because you have changed the paradigm of all that.
Exactly.
And so I want to, just for clarity's sake, I want you to repeat the concept that you are in essentially an impoverished country, and yet you created operational excellence. And a lot of people say it can't be done, but you did exactly that. Did I get that right?
We did that early. Now a lot of people are doing it. But when we did it in 1989, we're the only company who were creating a complete difference. And
complete and total. Not a little bit better, but juxtaposed to what's going on.
Exactly. Normal inventory turn was 4 times.
All right, I'm going to cut it there. Yeah, it's a little tough. Go ahead, Dan.
Just like here, how we all, whether we like it or not, bring home lean. Yeah. They did it there too, so it gets engraved inside of you.
I always hear people saying, I sorted this over the weekend, I sorted that over the weekend, garage, shop, pantry, all those sort of things. So it's nice to hear. Thing that I took away was the helicopter thing. I thought that was neat. You know, you didn't want to go because you didn't want to seem pretentious. But they said, you know, it's a matter of you showing up, not what you show up in. It's a matter of doing the work for the community. I know that's pretty important to be new. We'll see. Go ahead, Seth.
Yeah, also the idea of the innovator and the perfecter. Like you have Art Tatum who does stride piano and Oscar Peterson who comes in and perfects it, you know.
Yeah.
And in the same way here, there's people that come up with the idea for improvement and then there's one that actually executes the improvement. Mm-hmm. And then there might be somebody that comes along later that actually does the final adjustment to the improvement that really locks it in as a long-lasting benefit.
Yeah.
So I think that takes a lot of humility and viewing our success as collaborative. And not the John Wayne thing, not the hero, no heroes.
There's a big difference. Lean thinkers, going on ideas, we all collaborate together.
Sweet. Go ahead, Rob.
You're a CEO, you get to ride motorcycles in your spare time.
I'm not a CEO. And helicopters.
And helicopters. It seems like a really cool life.
Yeah.
But you have to ride them to poor villages.
Yeah.
Yeah, show up.
All right, anything else from Vinu? All right, we're chipping away at it. All right, we got Lori's birthday today. What's up, Lori? Happy birthday. All right. Some of the write-ins. Lori don't flex nothing.
Who's working?
Hey! Lori doesn't flex nothing because Lori knows she's got it. Most importantly, Lori doesn't take shit from Dan. And Lord of the Heijuka. So, happy birthday, Lori.
Thank you.
Yeah. Be sure to see Amy for your gift card.
Thank you. Right.
She said something happy. Takeaways from today.
Lori's birthday,
low-hanging fruit. Good one, Alex.
Ben's improvement on curve core.
Yes, awesome.
Continuous improvement.
There you go. Cool. Cool.
Creating environments that are juxtaposed to the rest of the environment.
There you go.
Right?
Nice. I think so. Sounds good. Mm-hmm. Seth?
Viewing like what we are building here as something that potentially could benefit the society and the culture, even if it's just in our own homes.
Cool. Awesome. Anything else? All right, let's roll on. Shout outs. I got a shout out for Rob for accountability and mind-blowing service. We cut a pedestal yesterday out of some scrap melamine and he decided to throw it away. Well, he decided to throw it away because he didn't want to kick a turd to the customer. So, good on you, Rob. Yeah. Any other shout outs?
All right, sweet.
Easy peasy. Let's roll it up. Cool. Meeting over.